Very good morning, students. Actually, in the last lecture, I told you that our topic of communication is over. Yes, it is over, but the parts of, if you look at the course title of the this course, extension 231, then its course title is the communication skills and personality development. So till last lecture, we have completed the primary things about the communication and process of communication. But from the examination points of view, some points are there which I cannot say it missed, but these are the some another dimensions of communications or communication. So very first is the nature of communication. That means how the communication is. So actually I have covered this in the very first topic, but still I'm just repeating for your sense. As communication can occur without uttering of the words, or any single word, you need not to utter any single word. That means if you are angry, then ultimately your eyes sides will be bigger one. If you somewhat bored, then ultimately your vocal, your whole body gives you response like way. So it can occur without uttering a single word. Then communication is a two-way process. As we discussed the Legion's model, last element of the Legion's model is the audience response. So this element is there which completes the communication cycle. And this is a two-way process. If communicator is communicating something, audience is responding. It is called as a feedback. So it's a two-way process. Then it has many varieties as per the situation, as per the time, different kind of communication. You can say style, you can say type, it is taking place. Then communication is a process. Process, yes. It's a irreversible, or the it is going to affect on the audience. So in that way, it is a process. Then it has basic three elements, that communicator is there, then message is there, and audience. If you remember the Aristotle model of communication, then he laid the three elements of communication. First one was the speaker, second one was the speech, and third one was the audience. So these are the three basic elements of the communication process. Then phases of communication, how the communication process is going on. If I'm talking to you people, then what I'm doing exactly, I'm expressing my views about the communication. Then that is expression actually. Then second phase of the communication is interpretation. Interpretation means what? You are interpreting your own, in your own way. Whatever the communication, whatever the things I'm telling you people, you are interpreting as per your own understanding. So that is the interpretation. And what kind of interpretation you have done with the message, accordingly you respond me. So that is the response part, or which is came from the audience side. So through these three phases, communication is taking place: expression, interpretation, and third one is a response. So these are the phases of communication. The most important thing from the examination point of view is a barrier in communication. Yes, we have seen the noise in the communication. Noise, we cannot say it's a barrier. Yeah, it is barrier, but noise is something different, which inhibits actually the communicator or the audience from being heard the message. But at each element, at each level, the communication element faces some problem to communicate effectively. So these are the some barriers in the communication. First one is a filtering. Filter out what exactly you do as you take the cup of tea. It's a full clear one, but your mother use that filter. आपण त्याला मराठी मध्ये गाळण म्हणतो. काय करतं गाळण का? It filters something, that means tea powder is there. It filters, no? So likely the in the communication process, whatever actually in that vessel, everything is there, but still what is most useful, that what is most useful, that is a tea, liquid tea. And for that sake we filter it, we just salt it, whatever the tea powder is there or the other ingredients, we just salt out it. So likely this is one of the barrier in the communication, filtering. As audience filter out some messages which he thinks is not important, getting as different personalities are there, and as per their personalities they respond to the messages. They will decide which is the most important message for me. So when they are going to tell or transfer this message to another one, so that time what they remember, just that thing only they are going to communicate with the others. So that is a filtering. Then distortion is again the barrier. We are not getting distortion, that means the whatever the message he got is not clearly understood. That is the distortion is. Then communication overload. If I am communicating too much information, then ultimately at last result will be the communication process, or the result of communication will be zero due to the communication overload. Then absence of redundancy, that means regarding the organization of messages. If the message is not organized properly, then that will be create the barrier in communication. Next one, if you go if you discuss each element of the communication process, then we can face the different type of problems. For example, for the communicator, what will be the barriers? He has a very good knowledge, but still environment is not good. So ineffective environment is the barrier or the problem in communication. Then disorganized efforts to communicate. If communicator himself is not prepared himself, he just passing the message, then it's ultimate aim of the communication process is to influence or to aware the people, that will be the zero. Then standard of correctness. If he is using the fuzzy word, fuzzy statistics, then his credibility will be going down. So standard of correctness. Then cultural value and social organization. Message is good, but if it is not consistent with my or the communicator's culture, then he is not going to pass the message wholeheartedly. Getting? So that is the cultural value and social organization. Then inaccurate symbol, that again create a barrier or the problems in the communication. Then wrong concepts. If he has not understood the communication cycle, if he is not understanding his audience, then ultimately that will create the barrier in the communication process. Then regarding the transmission of messages, channel part, wrong handling of the channel. If communicator fails to handle the channel in enthusiastic way, ultimately communication process will not occur smoothly. Then wrong selection of channel, that will create the blunder. Then physical distraction, that can create some problems. Then use of inadequate channel in parallel. Need not to explain these things. Then relating to the receiver, most important thing, that is the attention of the listener. If listener is not listening the messages, then what is its use? Then problem of cooperation, participation and involvement. If audience have decided to not to cooperate with audio, that communicator, then communicator cannot be succeeded. Cannot succeed. Then participation, active participation must be there. Involvement should be there. Unless and until it have, communication process will not occurs smoothly. Then problem of homogeneity. If audience and communicator are the heterogeneous population, then that will create some conflicts. So that will create the problem of in communication. Then attitude of the audience towards the communicator. If he is pessimistic, or we can say some prejudices about the communicator, then ultimately, for example, prejudices will be there according to the communicator caste, according to his religion, according to the area. So any communion that audience will have, if he is having such a prejudices mind, then definitely the communication process will be the zero. So for today, the nature of communication, then problems of communication, I think we should stop. And in the next lecture, we will go in detail in the non-verbal communication. That is important part actually, because the independent question will be there on the non-verbal communication. For example, define non-verbal communication and explain its forms. So accordingly, we have to prepare this. So for today, I think we should stop here. Thank you.